even the term that Maul had to brainwash us from, spending.
Spending.
It's not spending.
That's what he was talking about. He was like, man, should I spend it? I said, bruh, it's in your bank right now, and you can't see it, you can't touch it, you can't go get it. But now, he over there with the palm trees. He over there with the palm trees, sending me pictures in the palm trees with his feet up. He's living in his money. Guess what? Your money ain't gone. I said, bro, you transferred.
Not only is it not gone,
my money.
You transferred the money from, and that's the problem. A lot of people ain't living in their money. You ain't living in your money, dog.
You ready? All right. What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by the Bayesian sensation, Mr. Carl Wesley Phillips.
What's going on, y'all? What it do?
I got Dr. King in the building, 1977.
Man, huh? It was a great year, brother.
What happened?
Man, greatness was born.
Oh, I was born in 82.
I know. That's why I said greatness was born in 77.
I was born in 82, bro.
It might have been reimagined.
Yeah, you talking about.
It was reimagined.
It's reimagined.
Yeah, but it was born in 77.
Yeah, reimagined.
All right. Douglas.
Blessed.
What you got in there? Drink Organifi. Shout out to Organifi, man.
That's the rip.
The superfood green juice powder. Go to Organifi.com. Use the promo code SUCCESS.
Get the red one.
You could be like E.T. Get the red one. I'm a fan of the green. I'm a fan of the red. The turmeric. Come on, man.
How you doing? See, nobody ever asked you how you doing.
Oh, well, I'm used to it, bro. I'm self-sufficient is how I'm doing.
82.
You know 82. What? I'll be honest with you. I'm a little sad. If somebody play End of the Road by Boyz II Men. I've been a staunch advocate of my Skull Candies, as you all know. And by the way, do you know how many times I've been judged for wearing my Skull Candies? Because listen, y'all know.
Popular.
I like corded, and I wear the corded, regular, old school headphones.
Oh.
And I love them. They sound great. $20, you lose yours, whatever. $20.
Yeah, you don't care.
They got them right there. Yeah. Pull them open right at the airport. Boom. Pop them in, you're good to go. Now, I've been doing that for a grip, and I'm against the Bluetooth. I don't know why. I'm old school. You know what I'm saying? So I did not want no AirPods. First of all, they don't stay in my ears well. But then my wife was like, well, they got the ones now that's like,
it's wrap around.
The buds. Mm-hmm. You know, remember, because when they first came out, they were just the hard plastic. I promise you, I don't know if my ear structure is weird, but them joints just fell out my ears. You definitely couldn't exercise with them. And I was just like, I'm out. And matter of fact, I was rocking the Skull Candies all the way up to about 2 weeks ago. Dude came up to me in the airport. I can't remember his name. Shout out to him. He probably listening. He's like, oh, see, I'm a big fan of the podcast. What the hell you doing with corded headphones? I said, dang. But anyway, I'm sad to say that I've moved on to now the AirPods.
Mm. Ooh, come on.
No, it's not. It's
how
not.
Do you feel?
Well, here's the thing. So, one, force, right? Because they took this. Yeah. And then the little umbilical cord that you got to use to convert. One, you can't find that ever. It's just, you lose that.
Look at mine yesterday.
And then, you know, the final straw was, I had two of them. And I got the real boys, not the little off-brand boys, from Best Buy, the Apple joint. Bruh, and it kept, like, glitching. Like, you know, I got, you know, like almost like static in, and you got to move the thing around. I'm like, then I can't charge my phone and listen at the same time. And I finally broke down, and I told my wife, I was like, all right, just go ahead and get me. And so I've had them. I'm pretty sure I'm going to lose them. I thought I lost them at your house.
Oh, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? And then I was pissed because, I don't know, Carl, I'm going to have to have you look
lost
at him.
Lost the other day.
It's just one more thing to keep up with. Oh. I got my keys, wallet.
And it costs a couple dollars.
And it costs. Yeah. I told you, I just lost one.
Yeah, oh, yeah, you say you dropped one.
You can track them, though, if you lose the case.
Well, here go the thing. And I tried to do that at your house, and I put, and it would say connecting, and it never connected. I just end up finding them, but It wasn't even playing those.
Mine dropped. So watch this. And I know now that I play it back. Jordan, we're leaving Barbados. And I gave him the headphones. He was emotional. I was like, yo, just listen to something. Look out the window, whatever. So he put one in his ear. And he fell asleep right here on my shoulder. That sucker, he got up. And I'm like, yo, where the AirPod? Figure it just dropped in the seat. Nothing. Bro, I'm talking about I tore it.
Nowhere
I tore
found.
The seat out.
Yeah.
Nothing. Can't find it. I know what
Looked
happened.
On the floor. The
floor, forward, backward, flight attendant, nothing. Gone. I think whoever was sitting behind me, their bag was under the seat. It probably dropped right in their bag because it was like a briefcase kind of bag.
Yeah.
Whatever. I'm playing the sound in the plant, bro. Nothing. Gone.
Because just do the AirPods themselves play sound? Or
you
is
can,
it
you
the
can
case?
Do, and I didn't know that. They do. You could do left or right. Like, you could go in there and say left AirPod missing. And I was like, oh, that's kind of dope. Like, bet. I'm about to find it. It never connected.
Never connected.
Never connected.
You replace one?
So let me say it like this. I believe you can off market, but I'm like, I'm not about to
right,
go down
by the
that
time
road.
You do all of that.
Yeah, I'm not about to go down that road. But
nah, you can take it back to Apple when you find it. They can sync it for you for a low, low price.
wait, what?
So like say, let's just say I find yours
mm-hmm.
and I'm at the crib and I had lost mine. I could take yours up to Apple. They can take the case and sync yours with mine. So, like, if you ever found one, you can use it.
You can use it like
but
that?
You got to take it to
oh,
Apple.
Wow.
They take it to the back, sink it
first
for a low.
Oh, wow. That's terrible.
I'm not throwing
facts.
No random.
It's
facts.
It just got a little earwax.
Yeah, that, you got somebody else's DNA off your body.
It happened to me because I had a couple pair. So I ended up finding.
Another
but
set.
It was with the
oh,
other
yeah,
case.
Oh, yeah. No,
it was with
oh,
the
okay,
other case.
Yeah, nah.
So they like, no, we got you.
I
bring it in.
I thought you just find one up at the Kroger.
No.
You know what? Sync this up for me.
You
he said, I was homeless, bro.
Hey. you had switched to the big joints.
Yeah.
You, how was them?
Oh, fire, but my kids keep taking them every time.
Which ones?
I get them.
Oh, the Apple.
Got
oh, yeah.
Jalen took a pair. Then Jada was wearing the pair. Yeah, so
see, I can't work out with them because I sweat them out.
Well, those are the best to me because they don't fall. That's why I like them because they don't fall off. Like, they're not earbuds.
Yeah,
come out. They don't
No, no. I hear you. I'm just saying, like.
So why don't you get you a backup pair with the cord?
No, you know what you get though? The ones that connect over the ear. Those are. But you know what? To me, none of them. The sound these days,
it's not,
sweet.
Nah.
And it costs more.
That's why I'm
back
telling you,
day,
my skull candies
blow.
Is probably the best.
No,
this is my backup pair.
Are you always having them?
Yeah, so I got the ones you're talking about, but this is like my backup. Don't care if I lose it. Just
and I'll be honest with y'all.
Those are the best.
My favorite.
Oh no, I can't wear those.
Really?
No,
why not?
That don't stay in my ear.
You know what I have to do though? I just have to wear a skull cap whenever I work
over
out
it.
With that on.
Yep.
But don't. Sometimes your ears start hurting a little bit. No.
Not those, especially not those.
Those ones are my favorite. I lost the pair I had. I got to get another set. Like that. But the reason I do that is because, again, Bluetooth, when you talking sometimes, in, out, connecting, bro, you never got to deal with that.
You never got to worry about that.
Never.
No, I'm telling you. That's why I like the corded headphones, because sometimes, like I said, I'm in and out the car, it done connected to the car, it done connected. It's like, bro, it's too much, bro, the technology. So anyway, I'm officially, I ain't going to lie, I might come back. I need, by the way, Skull Candy, wherever y'all at, I think they're in Utah, actually. Josh told me in Utah. If I come back for a little endorsement deal on the pie, because I've been repping Skull Candy.
For a girl.
A strong 10 years I've been showing y'all
I got
love.
The Skull Candy,
I ain't got
small ones.
Free pair of Skull Candies.
No, all mine's there.
And they the best.
All mine. I got all Skull Candy. That's what
fire.
I use. Because the kids never take those.
Yeah, no, because they don't know. Yeah, they don't know.
Not cool enough.
Yeah, that's what they think, because they ain't going for quality.
Yeah.
They going for look.
Jalen definitely going for looks as he goes to the airport.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
With his diamond status.
Yeah, well, hi.
He got to have that with his diamond
status. Diamond time. By the way, shout out to Delta. I'm back on 360.
Oh, there he is.
I don't know if I said that already,
no,
but I am.
No, you didn't, because I didn't know.
No.
Can I give a testimony?
Oh, come on.
Had a little moment in the airport.
Praise God.
So, hey, listen to this.
Oh, he love his love.
Come on, man. Let me get my testimony.
Coaching with Jamal.com.
Can I get my testimony? Can I get my testimony, bro?
Coaching with Jamal.
You know what I'm saying? Now, he don't know the proper etiquette. You're not supposed to interrupt when a man giving a testimony. So, I'm in an airport with CJ. You know, we got caught in some traffic beforehand, right? And then we in Chicago, we get to the airport. CJ had a bag that he had to check in, right? Now, we about 45 minutes before the flight start, you know, take off. And, you know, they had that policy where they don't check in any bags, you know, anytime, you know, under an hour. And so this time, though, we were flying United. You know, CJ is like...
garbage.
Oh, he's garbage. Bro. I'm talking about he ain't even... trash. He's like playing. He don't even have a status. Yeah. They like, yo, this welcome to your first flight. They like, welcome to your first flight type deal. Hey, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, I looked at the skyline.
So we walk up to the counter. So first we walk up to the kiosk.
Yeah.
And then C is like... And then he like... He like, man, they won't let him check in a bag because it's like you under the time. Mm. So then all of a sudden we talk to a lady and she like, oh, you got to go down there. Like,
By the way, I was like 1 minute too late. You know
yeah, it was like right there.
Yeah.
But then all of a sudden, so then we get down there and there's a guy at the counter, you know, and he's like, you know, see, look, and the sign up there, it said platinum. Mm-hmm. I happened to look at my ticket. It said platinum member.
Come on.
So, but I'm sitting back because I'm so used to being with CC. Got everything, right?
No, no doubt.
CC the one got me, he the one that made me get TSA. He had me get clear. Yep. He had, you know, global. All that. Because I used to just be bogus. Yep. And then all of a sudden, C did this. Oh. He hit me on the back. Go up there. Tell him this your bag. Go talk to him. Tell him that you platinum. Go do your thing. I'm talking about he was on it. And then he stepped back, grabbed my little luggage.
You powerful.
Oh, I started off with these
gotta
words.
Know your rights.
I started with these words. Hello, sir. I'm a platinum United member.
Didn't he?
I started. Let's not make no mistakes. I'm a platinum United member. I got my bag. It says that we're a little bit late to check it in. I need to get this on the plane. My man said, absolutely, sir. Let me see what I can do. Oh, bro. I said, in that very moment, E.
Look at yourself in the mirror.
In that very moment, E, I said, this is what it feel like to be CJ. Yo, remember I just tell y'all the story where they 360 and they giving hearts to him and all of this. Oh, bro, my man took care. Boom, 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 boom. But they said it couldn't be done. My man got the bag checked in. Everything was good, bro. So I had my little moment on United. You know, platinum in United. It helped us out, bro.
Come on.
Being platinum on United is like being the best player in the G League.
See, you see how they do you? Yeah, yesterday, CJ was on
the... It's like you won G League All-Star MVP.
Oh, he loved me yesterday. And now all of a sudden, he here, now he back. All right, yes, see how it go,
It's like being the sweetest G League player. it's sweet. It's like your family's still going to come to the game, but don't nobody really know who you
but
are.
But he had
like
his pom-poms out yesterday, E. Give me a J.
Hey, listen.
Give me an A. Hey, it's all good.
It's about time you start contributing to this flight world.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a moment to talk about the game changer in hydration, LMNT, LMNT. Are you tired of those sugar-laden drinks that leave you feeling sluggish and dehydrated? Well, say goodbye to those because LMNT is here to revolutionize the way you hydrate. Picture this. A refreshing burst of flavor that not only tastes incredible, but also replenishes your body with essential electrolytes without any added sugar. Yes, you heard that right. LMNT offers a delicious alternative to traditional sugary beverages, ensuring you stay hydrated and energized throughout the day. And here's the clincher. LMNT isn't just a favorite among everyday enthusiasts like myself. Professional sports teams, they swear by it. That's right, top athletes rely on LMNT to keep them performing at their peak game after game. If it's good enough for the pros, you can bet it's the real deal. So why settle for anything less when you can fuel your body with the absolute best? Whether you're hitting the gym, conquering the trails, or simply need a pick-me-up during your busy day, LMNT has got you covered. Say hello to hydration done right. Don't just take our word for it. Experience the LMNT difference for yourself. Join the ranks of those who prioritize their health and performance. Make the switch to LMNT today and feel the difference with every sip. Your body will thank you. Just go to drinklmnt.com/success to explore their tantalizing flavors and take that first step toward optimal hydration. Again, that's drinklmnt.com/success. Because when it comes to staying hydrated, nothing else compares. Have you ever imagined turning your passion into a thriving online business? Well, that's kind of exactly what happened to us guys. We wanted to help people, and we wanted to come up with merch, products, books, whatever. And I never thought that we'd be running a successful online store. That wasn't necessarily our plan, but thanks to Shopify, selling our grind gear, books, and merch has never been easier. Shopify is the global commerce platform that's been by our side for over 10 years now. From launching our online store to hitting milestones that we never ever dreamed of, Shopify has been there every step of the way. Whether you're selling scented soap or outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell everywhere. Their all-in-one e-commerce platform and in-person POS system, it covers all bases. And watch this, guys. Shopify has jumped on the AI bandwagon and they have their Shopify Magic. It's an AI-powered all-star that helps you sell more with less effort. Plus, Shopify's checkout converts 36% better on average compared to other platforms. Shopify powers 10% of all e-commerce in the United States and has helped millions of entrepreneurs across 175 countries, including Allbirds, Rothy's, and Brooklinen. And don't forget about Shopify's award-winning support team. They're there to support your success every step of the way. It's simple, guys. Businesses that grow, they grow with Shopify. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/secret to success, all lowercase. Again, that's shopify.com/secret to success. Go there now to grow your business, no matter what stage you're in. shopify.com/secret to success.
Okay, so somebody hit me the other day, and I was like, oh yeah, I got to bring that to the pod. And I was frustrated, and it was like, yo, like they hit me a few times, and it was like, yo, I could tell you frustrated, you know, like, because I'm hitting you asking for advice. And I was like, no, I'm not frustrated you asking for advice. I'm frustrated you not applying nothing. Mm. And, you know, it's funny. Because I was thinking about this the other day, and I was like, because me and Maul were talking about, you know, his sermon and, you know, speaking and stuff like that. And I was like, yo, as much joking as we do, when it come down to speaking or anything like that, Maul lock in and be like, see, what do I do? Like, all jokes aside, we do a lot of playing on the pod and all of that, but, like, we'll really go in and he'll be like, yo, give me the feedback. And I'm like, nope, change this, do this, do this. And I'm talking about, like, Maul is a student, like, for real, will lock in. And then I was thinking about the same way with real estate. Like, when he's teaching, it's like, I'm locked in. I'm not questioning. I'm applying. And it's like, yo, I don't understand individuals who you like, I don't know how to say it, E. Like, you like a information whore.
Junkie.
That's the only way I know how to, mm-hmm. like, you like, I found out that they was calling other people asking the same thing to them. And I'm like, but you ain't applied nothing. And it's like, the person like, oh, you frustrated? Because I was like, I promise you, I'm not frustrated. I love you. But don't call me and ask me for advice anymore.
Right.
Because you have no plans on using any of the advice you're getting. And it's almost like, it's weird. I'm like, is this an attention-seeking thing where you like, because it was like, oh, somebody else was like, oh, yeah, they hit me. I told them to do. Hey, first of all, we gave different advice, but you ain't followed theirs either.
Neither of them.
And it's so funny because, well, I want to go there first, but then I also want to talk about the fact that, for real, like, the people paralyzed to make the decision. And it's funny because some of the coaching with ET questions related around, oh, should I do this or should I do that? You know what I mean? But first, why do you think people seek advice? Or I'm sure people come to you all the time, hey, Maul, and then you look up a year later and they've done nothing with it. I'm like, do you just want a bunch of information? Do you just want a bunch of advice that you could just sit on? Like, where is the difference between the person who take the advice and go crazy with it and the person who take the advice and just go get more advice?
Yeah. I say we start with culture.
No, this is your, bro. I said I was going to say.
Well, real estate, I know.
I just want to find out what that.
Yeah, a lot of people come to you.
Well, yeah, no, and I want to find out, again, what the difference is. You said something that was deep on the pod before, and we didn't get a chance to get to it, but you said, like, you know, I don't think real estate is my gift.
Yeah.
And I agree that, you know, your vision and everything else. Now, real estate is just, as you would say, the vehicle that you chose to use, right? But you could have used any vehicle, you know what I'm saying? Because that's just how you get down in terms of your personality and you know, things of that nature. But in real estate, the thing I do love about real estate is you don't have to be dynamic to do real estate.
No.
You ain't got to speak like E. You ain't got to be as smart as Carl or as good looking as me. You don't have to do none of that. Relax. Relax,
82,
bro.
Baby.
Relax.
Oh, bro.
82.
Relax. It's a system. It's a formula. So Maul could get the same, and they could be in the exact same financial situation, everything. You could get the same information to two different people and be like, there you go. Person A goes and starts building a mini real estate empire. Person B.
Come back and ask more questions.
Yep. Come back and ask more. Come on, B. Yep. I'm trying to figure out what that difference is, though, Maul. Say what's up to B, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Hey, welcome
what's
in.
Up, what's going on, fam?
You know what I'm saying?
What up? You good?
Yeah, you good. You can have a seat over there, bro.
What's good, with you?
Good to see you, fam. We got a big game tonight. You know
yes,
what I'm saying?
Yes,
young,
sir.
Young
yes, sir.
Junior. Almost the state championship time. You know what I'm saying?
Woo!
Yeah, yeah. Good luck to them boys. So my question is, what is the difference? Like, how can two people, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, let me say this to you. We said it yesterday, last time. We talk about, survivor mentality versus poverty mindset. Now, I want to say poverty mindset, but I don't want to offend nobody. And by poverty mindset, I don't mean that you're inferior. I just mean you were born in a either assistance, like welfare, or, and shout out to WIC. I just want to make sure, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to WIC. You know, Diddy had WIC, bro. I was getting the juice I wanted. I don't know, but we was getting it though. Yeah, WIC, women, infant, and children. They should have threw a M on that joke for man, because I was hitting it. So there's a world that you come into. I think about my grandma, you know, and my grandma, for whatever reason, you know, the route that she had the opportunity in her day, you know, was assistance. So quite naturally, you know, a lot of my aunts, they was doing the same thing, because that's where they, so when I say poverty, I don't mean you are less than, I don't mean you're inferior. I mean, philosophically, the way you go through life economically is you like the government is gonna do X, Y, and Z, right? And then there's another class, you know, that's like, yo, I'm gonna go get a job, go to college, I'm gonna get a job. And then there's those individuals who have a wealth mentality.
Crazy.
They see it differently.
Crazy.
Yeah, yeah, so.
Well, no, and you know, it's crazy, like, I don't want to say his name, but we got a homie who, he just know how to go get it.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like, and he used to know how to go get it on the street, and then he got locked up, and then he got out and was like, okay, cool, that didn't work. Yeah. And he's still going to get it. It's like, came up with a business idea, executing, and he back making money, and I'm like, dog, it's so many people who get the information and you still broke.
But I don't think it's the information.
Yeah.
I mean, the information helps. Don't get me wrong. But, bruh, and I'm just give you examples. It make real estate real. I get thousands of messages of people just like, man, I executed on the information, man. This is the best thing ever, bruh. This is crazy. Like, I've got financial success. But then I got another group of people that's like, yo, Maul, man, like, bruh, I did a property and, man, it didn't work out for me. And I'm like, bruh, it's the same information.
Yeah, but it's the different mindset.
It's the person. And I agree. It's the person.
The mindset.
It's the mindset.
Yeah.
But it's also the execution of the individual.
But I'm saying,
and if
you can't execute on wealth if you're using a poverty system.
But sometimes people think that the information you give them is just going to change their execution level. And it's not.
You have to get an execution mindset. So to your point, well, the reason why most of us don't execute because you were never taught to execute in school. You were taught that the person who had the most information or who could retain and spit back the most information is the person
who's
that wins.
The smartest. Right.
That's who he was taught was the smartest.
Right.
The person who could, if the teacher talked about science and said, this is what we're going to test you on, if you could remember that information and spit it back out, you were considered to be the one. Right, so our whole life, we've been rewarded for retaining information and spitting it back. We've not been taught to think or execute. Mm-hmm. Nobody.
Yeah, Ian, I got you. But I'm saying the blueprint is there. I'm not even asking you to do a whole lot of thinking outside on your own.
No, but
you
know, I have to be programmed though. So if you got a phone, everybody always talk about Apple. What's the other one?
Android.
Bruh, it's the same. It's an operating system, bruh. It's like OS and whatever Windows. Like, it is what it is. But when you look at a phone, all the stuff you're looking at, it don't matter. The people who really put the phone together, it is the operating system. And based on the operating system, you know the capacity of the phone. Mm-hmm. You know what the phone is capable That's of good, doing. Eh? You feel what I'm saying? So just because the frame is the same, it don't matter. It's the program. How has it been designed? How is it wired? So if it's wired a certain way, it could be used as a computer. You get the old flip phones we got. Those are phones too. But you can't do anything. I don't even know what the word is, like analog. Yeah,
you ain't got to go there. Go back to the iPhone version 4.
Yeah, 4.
Bro, if you try to do the stuff that you're doing now, Zoom, this, that on iPhone 4, it ain't happening. It.
Yeah.
All right? So to E's point, I think I'd say it like this. There are a lot of people that are, it's still the mindset, but you're afraid to let go of what you know and like how you know life. Like that's the big thing. Like, yo, I know all this. In order for me to actually execute on what Maul is telling me, I have to let go a lot of this. That's a tough situation. For me, it was, bro, you got debt on a credit card. Maul is the person that like, yo, I don't care nothing about debt on a credit card. Do something different. And I'm like, oh, you can't do that. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I think for a lot of people, there's a big struggle of letting go that mindset, that old operating system, because the reality
Dave Ramsey told you.
You got to pay off all your debt first.
But the reason why...
Maul, why you get all emotional when you said
that? Something about that name. Yeah. I don't know, man.
The reason why Maul can go, I don't agree with that philosophy, because Maul understands commerce. So people who don't really understand it, they're following somebody else's programming and trying to be successful. You feel me? So I'm trying to follow. So Maul... Dave Ramsey said, don't get in credit. Well, I don't know money. Yeah. So I'm going, I can't have... Bro, I did it. Me and Didi got rid of all of our debt. Yeah. But when you came and explained, it's not a debt game. It's an earn game. So what? You don't have no debt. That don't mean you got money.
Right.
So what? You got an 800 credit score.
Right.
So what? You still don't have money.
You're not living
so,
in bliss.
So for me, Maul, when I, to Carl's point, last time we talked about when I reset and was like, oh, no, E, don't focus on the what. Focus on the why.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm like, oh, I get what Maul is saying. Bruh, let me just be real. My whole life growing up in the school system, the way I grew up in it, to see his point, I always was excited about the star. Remember when you was a kid? And you do good, you get a star.
Yep.
Like, bro, they programming you.
Yeah.
So you getting a star, bro. It's like, bro, I'm getting a star. So in actuality, Maul, I don't care what nobody tell you, 90% of the kids are not studying to learn the information. They trying to get a star, bro. They trying to get an award.
Yeah.
They trying to get...
certificate.
They trying to get a certificate, bro.
That's how you trying.
No, I'm being for real. Yeah. So when I started working at Michigan State, I had to reprogram these kids. I was like, bro... bump a 4.0. Who cares? You about to be in $100,000 worth of debt to be able to say you had a 4.0.
Mm.
No, I want to know how are you going to apply this stuff you're getting from school and how you going to make money. So I had to change their mindset more because their whole life, A, B, C, they come up, man, my door to bro, I promise you. Jada, I didn't even know Jada was not academically astute. I didn't know because her grades were good. Mm-hmm. I didn't know until she went to college and took the SAT prep that my man was like, she has a learning disability. Mm. I never knew. Why? Because Jada always wanted to be a good citizen. Mm. So if a teacher told her, this is what you need to do to be a good citizen, she did whatever she had. To this day, bruh, if you tell Jada that don't go past that line, Jada like, oh, okay. Jada not going to ask you no questions. Jada like, okay, my dad said don't go past that line. I'm not going to go past
that line. I'm laughing because meanwhile, Jasmine like.
Bruh.
Which line? Bruh.
Jalen is
Jasmine got a foot on the line like, what happened?
Jalen is jumping on that joker. Jalen is jumping on it to say, hey, dad, I'm on the line. Ain't nothing happening. What's going on?
Yeah. I thought you said.
I'm like, okay, just give it a couple weeks. Give it a couple months and you're about to see what's going to happen. So I'm just saying, Jada is programmed. So to help Jada, I had to teach Jada, boo, you can't follow the rules because they rules. Mm-hmm. You need to understand the rules. And there are times you're going to have to break them because the rules will be designed to keep you from going where you want to go.
Yeah.
Jalen, the way he's programmed, I have to teach Jalen, bruh, you got to respect boundaries, bruh. Like, you don't have no respect for boundaries. So he don't have no problems exploring the world. Jada gonna stay in her box. So that's what I mean when I say you gotta figure out how a person is programmed. Most of us are programmed to get affirmation.
Yeah.
Most of us are programmed to get the star. We've not been told, hey, you gotta execute on it. And can I be honest? Man, I used to love to come home when I was in college. With the sweater on, bro. Mm. I wasn't going to nobody's class ball. I wasn't doing no schoolwork ball. But let's just be real. When I came back home and I came to the home church and
pumped.
I came in with the Oakwood boy on it.
Yeah, you got treated different.
Bro, I got treated all the people that grew up in the church.
Yeah.
That I was at the Mecca Mall.
Yeah.
Like, this the school that they train every kid to go to. Not only am I going, I'm doing ministry. I come back. I heard you started the Bell Tower Mall. I'm getting the bigger piece of chicken.
Yeah.
Hey, the pastor ain't even getting the chicken. They cashing me out. Yeah. People giving me money.
Yeah.
We never had a conversation about.
He wasn't even enrolled at the
bruh, time. I was on academic probation.
Oh, wow.
But guess what? We never talked about my grades.
No.
That's crazy.
We never talked about my grades and which classes I was taking, how many credits that I earned. Nobody ever asked me that. So see, most of my life I was affirmed from 1 to 18.
Yeah.
I was affirmed for having a form of godliness. I was affirmed for having a form, but denying the power thereof. Nobody asked about my grades, bruh, ever. And maybe if they would have, Ma.
Even on the 12th, when did they start saying,
hey, can I say what?
12 years to get
by
a phone.
By that time, they knew, but it was like, they was embarrassed because it's too late to say something.
Give me that money back.
Like, right.
You don't tell, I won't.
You understand what I'm saying?
Are you tired of feeling sluggish and run down? Ready to take charge of your wellness journey? Well, get ready to supercharge your life with Organifi, the ultimate solution for vibrant health. Organifi offers a range of premium, plant-based superfood blends that are designed to nourish your body from the inside out. With carefully selected ingredients like matcha, turmeric, and moringa, each sip of Organifi is bursting with antioxidants, vitamins, and minerals to fuel your day. Whether you're looking to boost your energy, support your immune system, or enhance your mental clarity, Organifi's got you covered. And the best part, it's quick, convenient, and it tastes absolutely delicious. And one of the things that I love about Organifi is that they keep adding products, guys. They recently added the Organifi Kids Protect. And listen, wellness starts from a young age. We don't want to wait till you get older to try to start taking care of yourself, right? So Organifi Kids is here to support your kids' daily immune health with clean, organic ingredients that are gentle enough for everyday use. With a delicious berry taste and no added sugar, it's the perfect way to give your child the nutrients they need to thrive. With powerhouse ingredients like orange, acerola cherry for vitamin C, elderberry for antioxidants, and propolis to naturally prevent sickness, Organifi Kids is like a superhero for your child's immune system. So whether you're nourishing your body with the original superfood blends or supporting your child's health with Organifi Kids Protect, you can trust that you're getting the highest quality ingredients backed by science. So why wait? Join the Organifi revolution today and experience the difference for yourself. Head over to Organifi.com/success and start living your healthiest, happiest life. And don't forget to check out Organifi Kids Protect because healthy kids are happy too. Organifi.com, Organifi.com/success.
So yeah. In our culture, you get rewarded for looking like you're doing something. Mm-hmm. You get rewarded because—
I see that all the time with real estate. Me?
That's
people just buy properties and they want to just, man, I got to make real estate realty. Oh, I'm part of that court, make real estate real. Yeah. But you ain't even executed, bro.
Yeah.
You got information to change your life, literally change your family's life, and you ain't executed on it.
Yeah, I saw that one yesterday.
He sent it yesterday. Yeah, I was like, bro, this need to be taught in schools. You saw it, right? I'll just read it for everybody listening.
It's his programming, though.
Bruh. No, I'm just saying, this should be programming for every human being.
It says or you should be coached by
Jamal.com. But it says the goal is to build a life that you don't need a vacation from.
Right.
I can't build a life if I'm not applying the information. If I were to be honest, my dude Ben always says, reality is undefeated.
Yeah.
Bruh, if you can't pay your bills, your wife mad at you, like if all these things going on, or you just not, you waking up and you know you're not where you're supposed to be, bruh, whatever you tell me, I'm going to give it a shot, 100% shot. I might give you a month and I'm going to do everything you say. If I see none, I'm going to try something else.
Yeah.
But like, I'm just saying, our goal should be to build a life that you don't need a vacation
from. How though? When nobody ever told you that.
What does that look like?
Yeah.
What is that? It's because it's cute. And people on Instagram, hey, oh man, build a life you're in vacation from. But most of y'all ain't even taking vacations. So what does that look like? What does that life look like?
I'm just saying, we were told how to take vacation. We were told.
2 weeks out
if nowhere else in the world, in Michigan, you working for GM, you know when you're supposed to take vacation. You don't get unlimited. It's a certain time frame. And then when we get it, we know where we going.
Yeah.
Bro, we going to the casino, bro.
Literally.
We going somewhere there's a casino. So we've been programmed to take the money that we make in. We would never invest it in a house because we was told, go get a car.
Yeah.
Bruh, go put some.
Hey, I'm not going to lie, shoes.
Bro. Bruh, put,
you want to know what amazes me? Bruh, I go to the store to grab a water, something like that. The amount of people playing that lottery, bruh.
Oh, bruh.
I'm like, yo, I'm talking about they in there like, bruh.
Unreal.
I'm behind homie. He give me 237s, folks. I'm like, bruh, he been about $500 on just scratch.
Program. We was programmed.
I'm like,
bro.
Imagine feeling like I'm not going to invest in trying to do something actively. I'm going to rely on a card.
And how many
to
years?
To scratch this joint off. And hopefully it give me some money.
Oh, it's going
to
give me some
not
money.
Not even hope. Don't use the word hope.
No. Oh, it's going to give me some
wishfully.
Money.
Wishfully.
No,
wishfully.
Bruh, I'm saying.
I'm going to get some money.
Yeah.
Bruh. No, I'm going to get some money.
Bruh. I'm talking about.
I don't know
what it is about this one gas station, but it's like lottery. I'm talking about they in that joint. And it's like, and they got the little casino boys in there.
Bruh,
I'm talking about folks spending thousands.
I was just in Vegas. They was all in there.
I remember the first time. I landed in Vegas.
I'm like, imagine thinking that that's your best option at becoming successful.
Don't act like I'm not gonna win though. They gonna let me win enough to think that I can win.
Practical thinking. I remember the first time, I'm young, I was in college. I landed in Vegas and I remember like hitting some slot machines right in the airport. And I put like 10 bucks, won like 5, lost by 6. And I was like, all right, this is going down a different route. But I sat there, I was like, yo, this is a business.
It's a business, bro.
The only way a business stays in business is if they're making more money than they're spending.
You've never seen a casino go under.
Bruh, I ain't never seen a casino. I literally had that conversation with myself. Like, yo, you could keep doing this, but let me just let you know that you're not going to win.
Oh, let me tell you something. And if you do win, I don't know if you see them stories. People be like on the slot machine, when they won. I won $10 million. They come and be like, "Oh, it broke." That was supposed to say $10,000.
What I'm trying to tell Maul.
No, I'm saying they're not even gonna let you win. Like,
yeah.
But I'm at.
Oh, yeah,
dog.
You don't have the taxes, Maul.
Bruh.
You won the car, but you don't got. But I'm just trying to say to Maul, this is why I'm saying I feel you.
Wow.
And this is why I said you need to get coached.
Yeah.
What
people don't realize about coaching.
Coach with ET or Coach
with Maul? Which one?
Coach with Maul.
If you come correct, you can get both of them.
You
get both of us now. But watch this, though.
Yeah.
Here's the deal, Maul. I used to always wonder, like, yo, why do people spend money? Like, you're getting information. You're not. You are, but you're not. When you get coached, the deal is you need to be with that person. And you need to be around them as long as it takes to get unprogrammed. Mm-hmm. See, that's what people don't tell you. That's why coaching is important. You got to get unprogrammed. And this is what I mean.
And I don't even know if that's a word, but that's fire.
Oh, it's fire.
No, so when you say gambling, bruh, my grandmother was sending us to the store. Yeah. Bro, this your grandma,
get
bro.
The scratch-offs?
Or play the numbers.
Play the numbers.
Period. Yeah. Play the numbers. So my grandma got us.
Well, no, you got to play your birthday. And then mix with your...
Bro, listen to me. Crazy. I was 8 or 9 years old.
Yeah.
And I knew the language boxer straight.
Yeah.
Mm.
Bro, how I know boxer straight? how do I know that?
But you didn't know real estate or invest.
I didn't know nothing about that. But I knew boxer straight.
Yeah. They didn't either.
Wow,
and here's the
bro.
Deal. I knew box was like, ooh, you got played. You won, but the numbers were scrambled.
Yeah.
So I would be going for my grandma like, I hope she get it straight. Because if she get it straight, we about to go to the Eastern Market and get this bologna. We about to eat. I'm just being real. In our community, when people made money, we got to eat different.
That's eat, yeah.
When I was at my grandma's crib, we ate different. Yeah. Like, you got stuff that you didn't normally get. Now, my crib, you know, my mom and them, they worked at, you know, Ford. So we ate. But when I was going to my grandma's house, my mother was smooth. My mother would never let us take food from our house to my aunts in the projects. We had to eat the way they ate. Mm. So however they lived, that's how we had to live. Like, my mom never made me a sack lunch, like, go in the closet and eat this.
Right.
Your cousins ain't looking. It's like, oh, you at your cousins. Whatever they eat, that's what you eat, right? My grandma used to send me. So then my grandma would send me, and then my uncles were sending me. So I'm a kid, bro. So I'm like, one of these days, I'm gonna get it straight.
That's it.
Bro, look, bro, we was young, bro. Mar, you know, they let you go 76, 79. They let you go in the store. I could buy alcohol for my father.
Oh, for sure.
Bro, I was young.
And a pack of cigarettes.
Bro, I was young. Like, hey,
with that
real
note.
Quick,
what
bro.
Edge?
Yo, that's.
Bro,
wow. I remember that.
I could tell. 12. 10? It didn't matter.
You had to give them the
note.
You give them the note and the money, and they read it. And then they put it in the bag
Grandma
and hand it back to
it.
You. And then, yeah.
So I'd be like, look, it's Father's Day. I just want to give my I just want to give him a pint of Hennessy. And they'd be like,
Pops
all right.
Pops drink Hennessy?
Yeah, Hennessy was his thing. So I'd be like, let me get that. And they give it to me. I go, so as a kid, you getting this stuff and you thinking, bro, I remember when it was black owned and then the Arabs came in and took over, bro. Like, I remember they cashed them out, like, here go 100 grand. And we was geek, like, yo, he just got 100 for his store. Then all the prices went, everything changed, bro. Like, I remember. So I was like, yo, when I get older, I'm going to be able to do this. I'm going to be able to do this. It had nothing to do with none of that. But it had everything to do with them programming us. Mm. So that's why being with Maul is so important, because Maul programmed me. Maul unprogrammed. He unprogrammed me first. Because the word that you're supposed to use, but it has a negative connotation, is brainwash. Yeah. Mm. But it has a negative connotation.
Yeah, yeah.
But really, that's what it is. You need to get your brain washed, clean, rinsed, so that you can get the new information. So when you told me, Maul, let me tell you something. When you told me what you told me about real estate, you know, I'm from the community, bro. So, you know, when you it's wordplay. So when you know how to wordplay, like rap, you flip it on him.
Yeah.
You flip it on his head. That's how you get him. You know, I remember when, what's his name, Carl? It wasn't Barnabas. What was his name? Bartholomew. When Jesus was like, oh, I saw you at the sycamore tree. He like, not only do I know you, I saw you at the tree yesterday under the whatever. He was like, what? You weren't nowhere near me. How'd you see me? So he was kind of blown by the information he was getting. Jesus will say something, that ain't your man, and the last five wasn't your man. And it's like, yo, how'd you know that? When Maul was like, Maul Jedi tricked me, like, you already in real estate.
Just on the wrong
like,
side.
I'm already in real estate. Maul, I don't do real estate. He was like, yes, you do.
Every month.
Jalen is in college, right? Don't he live in a dorm? Don't he got an apartment?
He got an apartment.
I was like, yeah, he got an apartment.
Real estate.
Don't Jada live in Michigan State's dorm? I was like, ain't you paying room and board? I was like, yeah. He was like, okay, don't you live somewhere? I was like, yeah. What does that mean? You already in real estate.
In real estate.
Already. You just on the wrong side of it. Oof. It was like a Jedi trick.
Yeah, yeah.
It was like, I was like Luke Skywalker and Yoda on them food. Maul was Yoda. I was like, yo, you right. I'm getting beat.
Every
I'm on the wrong side of it. And so then Maul, after that, I went with Trap. Like, okay, this week, bro, I called Marquay. Like, Marquay, bro, I've been around you all this time, bro. I've been hearing you talking. I'm like, bro, I'm taking everything out of and putting everything, because I need to learn.
Yep.
I need to sit at your feet. You know, you doing the scriptures, right? I need to sit at your feet. Trap been said, $100,000, put it in this, and I'm watching Trap online. Mm-hmm. Now it's at 2.5 million.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And I heard Maul say, real estate has been around since Adam and Eve. Once they got kicked out the garden, we was in real estate. At that
in
point.
The beginning. Bruh. First scriptures talk about real estate. That's in real the estate. Beginning. So, God created.
That's bruh, the real estate.
Ma, no, not keep where you're going. But, bro, if you read the Old Testament, it's all about real estate.
It's all about real estate.
Bro, the children of Israel, promised land, land. I read that a couple weeks ago. I was like, it. Yo, it's land. All land. Yep. I was like, how we missed that?
And Carl, me and Carl talked about this. When they left Egypt, God only gave them one command when they left Egypt. Only one. He told him to do one thing and only one thing. That's why I said Christians be on some dumb stuff. Meaning we're programmed with the word. We're not reading it for ourselves and figuring out what does it say. What was the one thing he told him to take? See, take a guess.
Your girl, hopefully.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm going to take your bride
now. That's good.
You know what I'm saying?
That's good.
I'm hoping
that's
he didn't good. Say just with the fella.
That's good.
That's good. That's good. I'll take a gas.
Yeah, no, no,
other than
good.
That, I'm not sure.
No, he definitely said that.
Okay,
sure.
Cool, okay.
It's in there somewhere.
What else he tell him to take?
Told him take gold.
Okay.
I'm like, hold on, this God, when they were in the wilderness, he provided all their needs.
Yeah.
Why he tell him to take gold?
Because he knew that was the biggest currency in the world. Like, you're going to need this to will and deal with them. Like, you're not going to be a superpower if you ain't got it.
Yeah.
Like, you're going to need this. But I'm like, gold? Why would you tell them to take gold? Because he said when they was in the wilderness, he provided all they need. He gave them manna. So he fed them every day. Like, so they didn't need, but he understood the context of the world and was like, yo, if you're going to will and deal, you got to have gold. And I'm like, but why are we preaching you just got to have Jesus? When Jesus said you got to have gold. You feel what I'm
saying? My.
He said you got to have gold. They said you just need Jesus.
Yeah.
And I'm saying, oh, that's why the worlds are not bowing to, okay, makes sense. And when Trap got me, I'm going to tell you, Trap got me when he showed me that the Latter-day Saints have $100 billion endowment.
Oh, yeah, they pay. Yeah.
I'm saying, what? What did you just say? He said, yeah, they got $100 billion endowment. That mean that this trip we taking our kids on, Disney. God was like, no, you need $100 million because now you need to take them to Disney. You need to do this, you need to do this, you need to do that. So the days of churches just.
Yep.
Now the church is in real estate because of Maul.
Absolutely.
Now the church is doing real estate because of Maul. So Maul washed my brain and he taught me that all that stuff you were taught, somebody taught y'all. And I'm going to say this, I know it could be controversial, but all that money my boys was making in middle school, YBI, Young Boys Incorporated, that those drugs they were selling, they didn't bring those drugs. Somebody brought those drugs into our community.
Yep.
And somebody allowed us to sell those drugs, and then they made money off of us.
Of course.
Going to jail, whatever. So what I'm saying is, somebody's programming us not to know about real estate.
Yep.
Somebody's programming us to go scratch the.
That's
somebody
good.
Programming us.
Yep.
It's on the news. I mean, it's on. My grandma used to be. Bro, I promise you, I didn't watch the news. My grandma would have us watching the news. Why? Because the numbers.
Yep.
Was a coming part of right
the
up.
Where the numbers was coming up. Yep. So it was spitting out. Blah, 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 and
they didn't have a news segment that was like, oh, here's
crazy.
A great investment property.
No, bro, that's that crazy. No. My parents watch the news every night. We just got back from Barbados. They watch the news every night, bro. The news starts with the lottery.
Yeah.
Bruh, I never even made that connection.
Carl, you know, the lottery got that from the numbers. Like, that used to be in a black community. You know, they used to run the numbers. And in the lottery, they saw how much money was being made in a black community.
I never really understood.
I don't even know why we watch the news now. I don't even understand why. Why. They're still telling me what the weather is. I'm like, bro, I got an app for that. I don't need you to tell me the weather, bro. Like, what are you doing?
No. Somebody who was just telling me the other day, like, no, I got to watch. They want to watch the weather. Like,
yeah, I'm crazy. Like,
okay. They be wrong anyway, but go ahead. Okay, when they used to run the numbers, how did the numbers work? I never understood. I never really knew.
Yeah. It's like, the same way with the lottery. You used to have a runner. He'd go around.
I'm saying, but who was trusting them to be like, all right, your numbers ain't hit, dog?
So,
I don't know.
It was a known thing in the community.
I know. I understand. Yeah. I just don't know how it worked.
So a certain time every night, they pull, you know, you pull from paper, and that's there go the numbers right there.
The same way like the lottery. That's supposed to
be. But I need to be in the room. See?
Oh, no.
But
no,
I mean, but
you weren't.
Right.
And you did get, if you remember Malcolm X, that's why Malcolm got into it with my man. Because Malcolm was like, no,
I hit.
I hit. And he was like, oh, no, the number was, Mac was like, no, that's what the number was. But my man switched it because he knew so many people had that number. So to your point, they did try to be, what's the word? They tried to be.
Nickel slick.
Nickel slick.
Come on now.
Wow. Come on. Come on.
Come on. You see how slick that. You see the nickel.
Yeah, but like I said, you think about, again,
program,
for those of you out there.
Bro, that's crazy.
You willing to take a flyer on life. You know what I'm saying? Like, you willing to be like, hey, I'm a go gamble it. I'm a try a lottery ticket or anything when there's perfectly good info. And I'm not even telling you, you got to be a dog. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, the person I was talking about before, and maybe I'm going to bring him on the pod at some point to interview him. But when I told you he just know how to get money, like, this dude, okay, brilliant. Let me just, yeah. I'm going to share what he did. Bro goes to prison. Cool. And he was moving. I mean, he had like Ferraris and Lamborghinis. This is a, you know what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Doing this thing. Gets out. Okay, cool. I can't do that no more. I was young, stupid. Let me get it legit. Bro came out, looked around, and said, okay, what's going on? All right, cool. I was like, what you about to do? Hustled his way up, just working, doing like some helping out people with real estate construction type stuff. Got enough money to buy an Escalade.
Yeah, I got you.
Bought an Escalade.
Know who it is now, yeah.
Yeah. Bought an Escalade, then hustled up some more money working, actually working, and bulletproofed the Escalade. Cost him like $70,000. To bulletproof the Escalade. So he all in on the Escalade, let's say 170, right? I didn't get all the details like that, but I was in the Escalade. Bulletproof the Escalade and charged rappers $2,000 a night and took it to LA and figured out somebody who could run the little app and they book it out for $2,000 a night. How long before you get profitable on your? And then went did this, and then guess what? As soon as he got the money back, went and got another one.
Another one.
Got a black one and a white one. Right. And they rented out. He getting $4,000 a night. And it's booked out 5 days a week.
Mm-hmm.
And the only reason I'm saying that is that's a different level dog right there. Like you now you on some like forward thing. Like that's a hustle mentality. Like I'm gonna go get it. I just know how to make money. I'm not even telling you, you got to be that forward thinking.
Yeah.
That's the thing that concerns me about people is like, you got individuals like that, which I think we do need to learn from, just like how they mind work. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. He just programmed to like, bro, I'm not finna sit back and be broke. You know
but
what I'm saying?
But you gotta understand why though.
But I'm saying, my point, Carl, is like, following a blueprint, and we're using real estate right now, but there's other things that have a blueprint on how to get paid and how to get money. I'm telling you, you don't even have to be a dog like that. You could just literally go, oh, okay. This makes sense. Real estate is about the numbers. You ask more. My favorite question of all is, how many times have you lost in real estate?
Never have I lost money in real estate.
And so somebody would hear that and go, that's impossible.
Right.
Bro, you never, Ma, you've been doing real estate 23 years. You never lost a dime.
Never. I'm not even going to blink. I'm keeping my eyes open. Never have I lost money.
I ain't never lost money following this blueprint.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Because you do your numbers up front.
Yeah.
You don't lose.
That's what I'm telling you.
You already know. Right.
So imagine people. Do you see what I'm saying?
Remember we talked about it. When you do your work up front, and I told C, a loss for me is, I thought I was gonna get $100,000 back, but instead I got $70,000.
Absolutely.
That's a loss.
No.
Right. But you literally
but
never.
I gained $70,000. Yeah. I didn't lose it.
The blueprint is so dope though. Cause the one he used at the house that they just sold me the same blueprint. Mm. Like you ain't even gotta rent it out.
That's what I'm saying. So Mar talked about it again. And to the layman's person who, again, like I told Patreon, we get my mom on Patreon at some point.
Ooh.
But again, why would Eric spend all that money on that house in San Diego and waste that money?
We talked about it beforehand. And we looked at what we do.
We looked at the number.
Before you made that investment.
Yeah.
We was like, and we looked at the trend. We looked
look at
values of the properties. And it was like, once we did that, because we looked at random comps, I showed E. I said, bro, you got that money sitting in the bank account. I was like, go ahead and live in your money. Remember we talked living your money. And he doing it now. I don't even know if you remember that conversation.
100%.
But I was like, bro, the money that you talking about, because he was kind of like on the fence. He was like, you know, Maul, should I put that money in there? Well, I said, bro.
Even the term that Maul had to brainwash us from, spending.
Spending.
It's not spending.
Because that's what he was talking about. He was like, man, should I spend it? I said, bro, it's in your bank right now. And you can't see it. You can't touch it.
I can't go get it.
But now, he over there with the palm trees. Mm. He over there with the palm trees, sending me pictures in the palm trees with his feet up. He's living in his money. Guess what? Your money ain't gone. I said, bro, you transferred.
Not only is it not gone, Chase is living in my money.
You transferred the money from, and that's the problem. A lot of people ain't living in their money, E. You ain't living in your money, dog.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul, with all your heart.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to the show, please, I'm begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.